Hello guys, here I am with a complete comprehensive Palera1n Jailbreak for Windows tutorial for iOS 15 to 16. Here is the new Palera1n Windows Jailbreak named Palen1x for iOS 15 and iOS 16 for checkmate devices only. This is Palera1n Windows Jailbreak. Unlike the other method which I posted previously, you do not need Linux for it. Palera1n is the only jailbreak currently available which supports the latest iOS 16 versions on checkmate devices. However, it does support the iOS 15 versions as well. Apart from the checkmate devices, if you are on iOS 15 on latest devices, meaning you can use the Fugu 15 Max jailbreak whose tutorial is coming very soon. So make sure you hit the subscribe button. This is a complete Palera1n Palen1x guide. Therefore, to keep your attention, let's see what is covered in this video. In this video, I am showing you how to download Palera1n Palen1x ISO file, make Palen1x bootable USB, and install Palera1n Palen1x Windows Jailbreak on iPhone. Also, how to install Palera1n loader, install Sileo, and reinstall the Palera1n loader. Before I start the process, you can see the supported devices on your screen right now. Also, the supported iOS versions. No other device is supported by this Palera1n Jailbreak. Now here is an important note guys, you must know about the tethered Palera1n jailbreak and semi-tethered Palera1n jailbreak. Although the tweaks injection supports both modes, but you may have to follow a specific one based on your device. For semi-tethered method, which is a rootful jailbreak as well, you need to have at least 16 gigs of free storage in your device. Then you can install a semi-tethered Palera1n jailbreak on your iPhone. It uses around 10 gigs of storage. Do not use this method if you have less storage available. You can then opt for rootless or tethered jailbreak. I have covered how you can install it later in this video. As I stated earlier guys, this is the complete Palera1n Palen1x jailbreak tutorial. Therefore, you must check these two points as well. Otherwise, you won't be able to install the jailbreak correctly. If you are on A10 and A11 devices, you cannot have passcode, touch ID or face ID on your device. Therefore, if you are on these devices, disable these security checks. Don't worry, you can set it later. I already have posted a video on how to set the passcode after the jailbreak. You can find the links in the description. Moreover, if you are on iOS 16, here is very important note for you. If you have jailbroken your device earlier, you need to restore your device first. Then you can attempt this Palera1n Palen1x iOS method. Otherwise, it will not work on your device. Keep it in your mind guys, if you already have attempted jailbreak on your iOS 16 device, restore your device first, then try this method. There are prerequisites you need to download before you start the Palen1x Windows process. Some tools you need to have on your Windows PC. First, you need to download Palera1n Palen1x ISO file as you used to do with the Checkerin Windows jailbreak. This is the Palera1n official website. Then you need to download a bootable tool to make it bootable. I do not recommend using this Rufus tool. It did not work for me. But you may give it a try. I suggest using this Palera1n tool. Here is the website for it. Moreover, you also need to have iTunes and iCloud installed on your Windows PC for this jailbreak. And both of these must be from the Apple's website, not from the Microsoft store. Here you can see, I already have downloaded all these in my computer. You can download all these from just one place. You do not need to separately visit all the websites one by one to download these tools. Simply go to the Google and search Palen1x Windows Tech Acrobat. And open this Tech Acrobat link. This is the complete and updated guide for Palera1n Palen1x Windows jailbreak for iOS 15 to 16. Here, scroll down and download the Palen1x from this link. Palera1n team made this index link. All the versions are available here. Download the latest AMD one. When you are watching this video, you may find the newest version available below this. Then download that version. After that, here is the Palera1n tool download link. Use this to download. And here is the direct download links to iTunes and iCloud from the Apple website. Go to the link and click on the skip button here. And the download will automatically start. Also, if you have iCloud and iTunes installed from Microsoft Store, First, uninstall them and then install this new one. Here are my all the files. I already have downloaded the required things. Now first, install iTunes and iCloud if you haven't. Then restart your computer. The restart is a must, guys. Do it and come back. Once you are back, let's make the Palen1x bootable USB. For that, first install the Palera1n tool and open it on your PC. Now attach an empty USB to the PC. Any storage USB is good to go for it. Once the Palera1n tool opens, select the downloaded Palen1x ISO file here. You can just drag and drop it here. Then select the attach USB from here. Lastly, click on the flash button. This will make the Palen1x bootable USB to install Palera1n Jailbreak on your device. Don't worry if you see these unnecessary prompts on the screen during this process. Once the bootable process is done, now restart your computer. The next process is to install Palera1n Windows on iPhone using Palen1x Windows bootable USB that you just made. Hello guys, if you have made this far in this video, hit the like button, also the subscribe button to help me reach 2000 subscribers. As the bootable USB is ready, keep it connected to the PC as you must boot your system from the attached USB. Restart your PC and go into the BIOS settings. For different PCs or laptops, different key is used to enter into the BIOS. For me, the escape key works. You can try by pressing F2 or F12 or F11 keys. But if none of these work, you can search on Google for your model. Here is my BIOS screen. Now go to the boot option. Then go into the boot order type. Here, move the USB to the top of the list. You can see the instructed keys on your screen to move it. After that, press F10 key to save and restart your PC. The system will now boot through the attached USB. Guys, here is one more very important point for you. For some of you, if you see this error, you need to disable a secure boot from the BIOS settings first. Do not get frustrated, guys. I will help you fix this error. Restart the system again. For that, press Alt plus Control plus Delete buttons. Then enter into the BIOS settings. Here, navigate to the security settings. Most of you will see the secure boot option here. Disable it. After that, press F10 key to save and restart the computer. This time, the system will boot through the attached USB and you will see the Palera1n written at the top. For my laptop, the steps to disable the secure boot are different. Once you restart after the boot settings are updated, you will see this screen on your PC. If you see this, you are going well. Here you will see 5 options. Select the first one and hit enter. By default, the rootful or semi-tethered option is checked. You can see it here at the top. But which option is better for you? Rootless or rootful? Which one you need to select for your device? I have already told you about this earlier in this video. You can rewind the video and watch. I am using the rootful option as I have substantial free storage on my device. Just in case you are going with the Palera1n rootless or tethered jailbreak option, you need to change it to the rootless. For that, go into the switch option and change it to the rootless option from here and select OK. Now go to the options section. Here are multiple options where the debug option is by default selected. But if you are installing the semi-tethered or rootful Palera1n jailbreak, you need to select the first option, create fake FS as well. This is not necessary in the rootless mode. To select the option, press the spacebar and return to the main screen. Now attach the device you want to install Palera1n Palen1x jailbreak on with the computer. Also, hit the trust button on the device. Now on the computer, hit enter. The device will enter into the recovery mode first. And when it starts the DFU mode, put your device into the DFU mode manually. I I am using this method to put my iPhone 7 in the DFU mode. Press and hold the power plus volume down button for 10 seconds. Then only leave the power button. Keep holding the volume down button for next 8 seconds. Then leave this button too. You will see the process will automatically continue when the device is entered into the DFU mode. As you can see, the process is going on. You will see the Apple logo first on your device, then the jailbreak process. It may take a little while, it can take around 10 minutes. But if you see any errors regarding USB lib, do not worry, ignore those errors. While the process continues, if you are on A9 or below devices, you must rerun the jailbreak if your device gets stuck on Pongo booting. The process on your device will stuck. You will only see 4 to 5 lines at the top. That means the device is stuck. To rerun the process, come back to the main screen. For that, type Ctrl plus C, then type exit. It is a command and hit enter. You will be on the main Palen1x jailbreak screen, and from here, rerun the jailbreak process as you did earlier. Once the process is completed, the device will reboot. At this point, you may or may not see the done message on your PC. We have installed Palera1n Windows Palen1x jailbreak, but you need to install Palera1n loader on your device to jailbreak it. Keep the device connected with the computer and make sure the Wi-Fi is enabled. Let's see how to install Palera1n loader with Palen1x jailbreak. Come back to the main screen. For that, type Ctrl plus C, then type exit. It is a command and hit enter. You will be on the main Palen1x jailbreak screen on your computer. Once you are on this screen, go into the options section. Here, make sure all the items here except the last one, which is debug, are deselected. If any other option is selected, to deselect that, highlight that option with the arrows key and press the space bar. Once all items except the debug are deselected, press enter button to come back to the main screen. From here, hit enter on the start option. As you hit the start option, look at the PC screen to see if the device is detected. Then put your device into the DFU mode. If it's not detecting the device, disconnect the device and connect it again. And also hit the trust button on your device. Now again, the device will first go into the recovery mode, then put it into the DFU mode. Once you do it, the process will continue. And this time, it will not take too long to install Palera1n loader using the Palen1x on your device. Once the device boots back, you will see the Palera1n loader on your device's home screen. Make sure the device is connected to the internet to show that up. If it shows up on your device, hit the like button, guys. Also hit the subscribe button. More interesting videos are coming up. Here is the loader, guys. Now let's see how to install sileo with this loader. Open the Palera1n app and tap on the install button. Tap the allow button on the pop-up. And then the respring button. Once you respring it, you will see the sileo installed on your device. Open the sileo and upgrade all the packages before you install any tweaks. Below in this video's description, I have given all the compatible tweaks list along with the repositories. Now finally, I will show you how to reinstall the jailbreak. As you know, the Palera1n jailbreak is a semi-tethered jailbreak, which means once the device is rebooted, you will be out of the jailbreak state. You will probably be thinking that you need to repeat all the installation steps again. No, that is not the case. You do not need to create the fake FS every time. It's just needed once. You only need to reinstall the Palera1n loader on your device to re-jailbreak with the Palera1n Palen1x jailbreak. To reinstall the Palera1n loader, connect the device with the computer. go to the Palera1n options screen and hit enter on it. On the next screen, go into the options and deselect every option here except the last one, which is debug. Return to the main screen where the first option is start option. Hit enter on the start option. The device will go into the recovery mode. Then you need to enter it into the DFU mode. The process will continue. Do not worry if you see libusb errors on the computer screen. Once the device is turned back on, the Sileo will start working again and all the installed tweaks as well. This is how to download Palera1n Palen1x Windows Jailbreak on iOS 15 and iOS 16 using Palen1x Bootable USB on the Checkmate devices. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. This is Palera1n Palen1x Windows Jailbreak installation guide. The next video I am uploading is how to uninstall it. The process to uninstall or remove the Palera1n Windows Jailbreak is a little different as compared to other jailbreaks. So make sure you hit the subscribe button.